the new thing and continuing on to Chronos momentum. Like that would be my problem, is like not having the idea, not reflecting on it, because you need to keep working on what you're working on.
Yeah, you got stuck. Yeah, I think especially for, you know, for introverts, right? Like people just love the ability to stop everything and think as much as you can. I totally understand what you're saying. I think there's just real pragmatism there, right? Like you just have to know your limitations. Scheduling for me has been a big thing. If I know when the next time I'm going to be able to think about this is, it allows me to set it down better. I tend to want to fixate on something if I don't know when I'm going to think about it next. Because I'm afraid I'm going to lose it, right? So write it down, schedule, next Wednesday, 1:30, I'm going to take 15 minutes, I'm just going to think about this. Cool. Let's see, we've got 15 minutes, right? That's great. All right, so I'll share some of this stuff. I'll have to skip over a little bit, I think, but that's okay. Really, I think you're like grasping more what I really hope you're to get than necessarily these tools. And so all the stuff I'm going to show you is open sourced. You're free to use it. You're free to look at it. You're free to learn from it, steal small bits of it, call it your own, whatever. That's totally fine. So I'll have links at the end as to where you can find all this stuff. So one of the first issues we dove into in deployment, and so I'm going to share kind of like how I steer and lead into this, DevTools. One of the first things I noticed is that they started every project from scratch. Don't be embarrassed. They all do it. But obviously that's not a great reproducible way of working, right? Like, you lose a lot of overhead there. So, I gathered the team together and I just started asking them, what's useful bringing to every single project? You can have this every single time you work, every time you work, the first thing you do is what? And we just wrote all this down and we put together the theme boilerplate. Like, okay, we make custom themes. That's a lot of what we do. So we should probably have a theme that we start from every time, right? Something that we know we're going to use again and again and again. And so I'm about to dive into that. And what you're going to see now is not what we wrote 4.5 years ago. It's what we have now, right? A lot of time, a lot of intentionality. You know, I'm eating that to death, but it's kind of a thing to remember, right? We took regular time and work together, and after projects, we'll discuss as a team what was some stuff that we learned from that project. And there'd be things like, oh, I've noticed that we added this feature to the last few projects. Or, I had to set up, you know, this thing this time, and I would like it every time we work. I think it would really help to speed us up. Or, I think this code is getting dated, it should be improved. I just had an idea. Whatever it is, we write it down, we review it at the end, we apply it to our starter so that we can grow and do better in the future. We can work better and faster as we work. And the key here is time. Don't just fit it in somewhere. Like, actually make the time to do it. Okay. So the first thing that we wanted to kind of dive into with this was organization. WordPress has like a convention for organization, right? It's a little short scope. So with plugins, you have no idea where anything is except for the one main plugin file. With themes, you have a general idea of where the templates are, but that can get kind of gnarly. And you know where functions.php is. just look natural. Okay, so, I mean, really the first thing was documentation. Throw a README in there so that anybody we bring on board knows exactly how to use it. Instructions. What is this? What are they looking at? How do they get started? How do they use it? All this kind of stuff. It's amazing what a single file with some instructions can do for your team, so you don't have to explain it to them every single time. So organizationally, and I'll move very quickly here, but we just wanted to trim it up. The templates are not just hugely in here anymore. Like if you get working on a big site, you have templates on templates and templates on templates, and your group can get enormous. So we broke it down such that like, oh, so we have our views, and in there we have page. Oh, and there's front page and page. And there's post with my archive and my single. A nice organizational structure where people can always find what they're looking for. Next up, basically would be assets, where your SAS, your images, your JavaScript, all that kind of stuff. And then source. I wanted everything to kind of feel more object-oriented, to load nicely. We use PSR more so that things would be namespace, such that if somebody's working, with this example post type, they know exactly where it is. How do I know where this is? Well, because the namespace is post type, therefore it's in source post type example. If you're not familiar with PSR more, it's a wonderful thing. It's a way of finding whatever the heck you need. So that was organization. I know there's just kind of popcorn lessons here, but I'm just kind of trying to share like what the observations are. What do we do about it? Post types and taxonomies. Like I just showed you one here. I wanted a way of being able to, we use a lot of post types and taxonomies in our custom projects. I wanted a way of being able to quickly spin them up, know where it is, so you don't just grab a theme and then do a search all for registered post type and then go through. And then also you have code that pertains to a particular post type, right? Maybe you're doing something with pre-get query, or pre-get posts, or whatever it should be. So I wanted like a single nice place for it to be. And then it's broken down a little bit. You have your slug, you have your labels, so you know exactly where those are. Them later if you want to. And then you have your typical arguments if you're used to a registered post type. Well, there's everything that you want. So let's see. So next up. Was assets and task runners. So CSS and JavaScript are really vital these days, right? And pre-compilers and using things like SAS and ES6 and all that stuff, it's not as much of an option as it used to be, right? In fact, a lot of tutorials out there right for this stuff. And it's also getting to the point where the benefit is outweighing the extra complexity. The thing that really turned me off initially to task runners, here's like a little gem for you here, just in case you've never heard of this. The thing that I did not like about task runners at first was that I worked with multiple teams like this. You had one guy on the team who understood how the task runner worked. It was the grunt guy, or the gold guy, or whatever. Like, there's that one person, and every time something didn't work, everybody was like, they didn't know what to do with it. Like, they're trying to write CSS, and you have this compiler in Node. how do we do that?
There's a constant thing we're observing and reflecting on. And so it made me very happy that finally I can just hand out the thing and we immediately have a way of working with our assets. Fourth, actually, I'll just skip that one for time's sake. So the last thing was, I call it the loop new. So when I first got into WordPress, I have to confess the thing I liked so much about WordPress, right? So much to like about it. The thing that just killed me was the loop. Anybody else like with me on that one?
Yes.
Thank you. I get it. It's very much a when you don't know if you don't know PHP but you still want to build stuff, the loop. But if you're trying to do anything more involved, then it's kind of terrible. I just wanted a way of working with things that made sense. So very quickly, I apologize. I have to move so quick on this one, but I made something called WP controllers. This is also open source. But basically it gives you a here's the README once again. But basically it gives you a way of being able to do things like get meta really easily. Or grab, you know, like your related stuff, or grab your terms and taxonomies, or what if I want to excerpt for this post and I only want 50 words,
oh,
and I don't want to have to add another filter. There you go. And so we use that on every project, so let me show you an example of what something looks like when it's using that. So if we go to post type, page, look at that. Node. There's your title, there's your content. How easy is that? So we use that on our project. It's extensible, you can add all sorts of stuff. If object-oriented programming is your thing, and WordPress is your thing, I recommend checking it out. Even if you don't use it, you might find something in there you're like, clever, and use that. Okay, wrapping up. So, I want to conclude again with friends, fun, boss, online. Everything I just showed you, as interesting as it is, that is the result of just a lot of pausing, planning, reflecting, observing, discussing. I want to give you, help you to just feel empowered to do that with your team. So that you can create your own starters, you can create your own controllers, you can do those things yourselves, and they'll grow with you, because as you grow, you'll grow those with you. We're in a business that has innovation. The internet moves so fast, right? Like, am I the only one that gets dizzy sometimes? I log in and I'm like, oh, the new coolest thing is Gulp. The